Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure Vue Signature Pad using the Vue CLI command and Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Inputs package. Using the Vue Signature Pad, end users can sign their names as verified digital signatures on desktop and mobile applications. I will show you how to configure this control along with a few of its basic features like changing the background color, stroke color, velocity, minimum and maximum stroke width, and applying a background image. I will also show you how to save the signature as an image and clear the image in a signature pad. Let me show you the application creation process using the Vue CLI toolchain. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Vue, Node, and Vue Class Component. In the command prompt, run the command npm install global Vue CLI. I'll create a new project using the Vue create command and provide the app name My Vue Project. You will be asked to pick the preset. I choose Vue 3. I navigate to the desired location and install the Vue Class Component library using the command npm install Vue Class Component. Then, install the signature package using the npm install Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Inputs command. Now, I open the project in VS Code. To start using the component, navigate to the app.vue page. Import the signature component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Inputs package and register this component plugin to Vue. By doing this, all the component's child directives are also globally registered. Then I add the EJS signature tag to the template section and import the Bootstrap 5 theme styles into the style section to apply styles to the signature component. Next, the Syncfusion license key must be registered. Open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the Vue trial license. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, a license key is mandatory in Vue projects to avoid license warnings. I then run this project using the command npm run serve. See, a signature pad is rendered. Now I can sign using my finger, pen, or mouse. Next, I will show you how to change the background in stroke color. In the data method, I define a variable, bgColor, and assign a value, red. Define another variable, custom_stroke_color, and assign, white. Add the background color property and assign the variable, bgColor. Then, add the stroke color property and assign the variable, custom_stroke_color. Check now, the background color of the signature pad is red, and the stroke color is white. Here, the stroke thickness is calculated based on velocity, minimum and maximum stroke width. Velocity is used to calculate the thickness based on the pressure of contact on the pad. The default velocity is 0.7, the minimum stroke width is 0.5, and the maximum stroke width is 2. Now I'm going to increase the stroke width. Here, I set the velocity to 1, the minimum stroke width property value to 2, and the maximum stroke width property value to 5. When I draw the signature, the stroke width is increased. Next, I will show you how to add an image to the signature pad. Add the background image property and assign the Syncfusion image URL. Check now, the signature pad has a background image. Next, I will show you how to save and clear the signature using a Syncfusion button. I install the package, Syncfusion EJ2 View Buttons. Then I import the button component from the Syncfusion EJ2 View Buttons package and register the component to Vue. Add the wrapper element with ID as action button and include the EJS button to the template section. I provide the button label as save. In the save button, add the onclick event and assign the callback method, save sign. I define this method in the methods object. I can save the signature in the pad using built-in method, save. To call the built-in methods, I use ref property. In the signature component tag, include the ref property and set the sign object. Here, I call the save built-in method using its instance. I need to pass two parameters, image format and name to save. You can save the image to PNG, JPEG and SVG formats. Set the image format to JPEG and file name to signature. Include another button with the label, clear. Replace the onclick callback method name to clear sign. I define this method in the methods object. In that method, call the built-in method, clear, using the signature component instance. In the style element, I add a margin style to align the button component. Then I comment out the background image property to save the signature with the red background color. Look here, I sign in. When the save button is clicked, the sign will be downloaded as an image. When the clear button is clicked, the signature will be cleared. Next, I will show you how to undo or redo the signature on the pad. I add a button with caption, undo. Add the onclick method as undo sign. Add another button with caption as redo. Add the onclick method as redo sign. In the methods object, define the method undo sign and call the built-in method undo using signature instance. Then define the method redo sign, call the built-in method redo using signature instance. Check now, I sign in and click undo multiple times. Then redo the signature. Finally, I will show you how to disable the signature pad. I add the disabled property and set its value to true. Check now, the signature pad is disabled. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion Vue signature component using the Vue CLI command and a few of its basic features. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.